we'll probably still go. Yeah. I will turn that down. Okay.
We should probably go live. It's 9 p.m. May we go live, please?
You ready, guys?
Yes.
Okay, so I will just mute you real quick.
Fucking cheesy. Wonderfully.
Sheila, no. Tell Sheila that I will just mute you for 2 seconds and then you're on again, okay? Okay, see you later.
Josh, we're going to somehow, because like Shayla can't. Okay, if we push Shayla way back on the table, but like she'll be smaller than this one.
You're listening to Red Gorilla Network, the Kong of Casting.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Real Seduction Radio. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Real Seduction Radio. Is my voice on now? Here we go. Let's keep it real. R-E-E-L Seduction. Tonight with the lovely Hall of Fame. Champion, I would have to say, female performer Shayla LaBeau.
Hey, insanely,
wonderfully hot and sexy Amy Faye, the brand new anal queen yet to claim her crown.
Hopefully soon.
We call her the anal princess at this point. Let's keep some more Sarah McLachlan playing in the background. That was groovy. Can we? Oh, we're done. We'd have to actually go outside and ask two guys to open the door so we could push the play button. I'm just kidding. Red Gorilla Network. Tonight we've got Josh. What do we call you? What's your like porn radio name? You don't even care, huh? Shit. Just Josh.
I haven't thought of one yet.
Josh the Pizza Guy.
No.
No, that's really fucking cheesy.
The Delivery Man.
The Delivery Man.
I didn't even get to meet the guest.
Oh my God, Amy Faye. Look at me really? Now.
Nice to meet you.
I met her like I think 8 days ago.
A long time ago.
This writer from Fox Magazine is like, dude, we've seen and done so much.
She can't see me, huh?
You should really turn.
I'm not in her camera.
Turn that over to Shayla. But Shayla Vision needs to be a part of Josh.
There we go. Is that good?
Let's get her.
Oh, Josh. Nice to meet you, darling.
Spin that up just a tick more.
Like towards him?
Josh.
My baby?
Josh is our station manager. At the Red Gorilla Network.
I actually read a little bit about him. He is like the big kahuna in those parts, right?
Yes. Well, his wife, Bukkake Behane, Bukkake B. I never get it right. I constantly get like, change this. Don't do that. And this is the calm, quiet guy that put the website together, that makes all the magic happen, that hung the screens, that painted the studio, that brought in the furniture, and basically does everything behind the board besides that. Josh doesn't do much.
Jack of all trades.
Wow.
Yes.
Dude, in other words, he's not here. We're not doing shit.
Yeah.
Dude, you put on a coat.
We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him.
Well, I had it on earlier.
Josh,
this is my producer coat.
Shows up in the corduroy fucking blazer. Dude, nothing's more porn says corduroy blazer. Then wait, you got to throw in cop mirrored shades for no apparent reason.
Oh, yeah.
For no apparent
just,
reason.
Just, you know, wear an army shirt and wear like sleazy Arizona PD
the shades.
Shades
go perfect with that jacket.
Teen anal also follows with this look.
Oh, God.
The top is no pants, boxers, and white socks.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Not even, you're just wearing like flip flops that don't even match. Nice.
Flip flops with the socks on.
Shayla, talk to me. When did you first get into the adult industry?
Oh my God, 93.
Wow.
I was two years old.
A long time ago.
That really, no, that's.
I've grown up in this business.
2 years old.
That's the, really? Oh God, now I feel really creepy because that's the same year I started shooting porn, too. It was 1993.
Really?
For Bobby Hollander over at LBO Productions.
93, wow.
The Neighborhood Watch series. So fucking dirty. And I don't remember tests or permits or IDs or we just shot people and said, hey, bro, what's up? And gave them cash, and I think we signed stuff, but, like, I was so fucked up back then.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. The 90s in porn? It was completely outlawed and underground then.
Yeah.
You had to work a deal with the police.
Go ahead.
No, please.
I remember actually being on sets, and they would shoot, like, the European version back in the bathroom. And so it's like you're shooting, like, a regular set, regular scene. I was under contract with Paul Norman. And there were things that were illegal to shoot here in the United States. So they take
like
the
what?
To
what
the
was
side.
Illegal?
I'd shoot like the pissing and the fisting
pissing,
and
yeah.
all the things that were illegal for us to shoot, and then they'd send it over to Europe.
There was a lot of pissing videos. I remember the pissing videos all over the place.
Did they make it illegal at some point?
They have to.
2001, in federal court, they made L.A. County the only legal place on earth to shoot pornography.
What?
True story, and no one seems to remember that in L.A. County after the condom law, saying you have to have a condom to perform sex, or you can't work in this town. Mm-hmm. So that's the new rule. They added that on top of the only legal county on earth to shoot porn in.
That sucks.
So basically, like, everything's illegal. That's cool.
It's not okay if you want to do a condom scene.
I mean, are they even using that law? I mean, are they abiding by that law or not really?
That would be a huge legal thing that would kill me if I told you the truth.
Oh.
But, yeah, let's just say
everyone's very good. Like,
the city's losing basically $22 million a year. Because we're not giving it to them in taxes.
Really?
Talking to that thing. Make it like a penis. Yeah. See, she hears penis. She's like, okay,
it's like, okay, shit.
Bam, killed good Mike. We don't care.
Don't bite the penis.
It's so cute. It's so fucking big, but she can handle it, but, can the mic handle itself?
I do well, have the penis mic. Everyone else is like regular ones.
Yeah, see, because you're special. You get the big, thick, hard one.
Yeah, but porn has definitely changed from then until now. It has had many incarnations, actually, through the years.
Talk to me.
Through the decades. What do you mean? I'm talking to you, babe.
Well, we were doing like film, and then it switched to tape. And then we were kicking out VHSs. Do you remember actually renting projectors and film reels?
No.
Like 70, like when you were a little kid, like did you remember your friends like going, dude, we got a projector?
No, no. See, that was pre my time. You're older than I am, babe.
Mm. How old are you?
Old enough.
Shayla's 19.
69 was a very good year. Let's just put it that way.
Okay. Oh. Stop, dude. Okay. Well, like, if you would have noticed your creepy, like, dudes around you when you were little, they would bust out a white sheet and tack it up on the wall in the basement and start bringing beers in. And then the dude would be like, bro, I got a projector. And the other guy would be like, I got a reel. And then you'd spool up, like, 16-millimeter pornography in your basement. But then as you drank too many beers, the film would jump a sprocket, fucking burn a frame, and you're like, oh, ha, ha, no more porn tonight. Kill the film.
So you had to rent all you'd the actually
gear? Rent a fucking film projector, and then get your real film at the dirty porn store behind the
so
camera.
So it was a lot more expensive back then, too, then.
It was all made for daily consumption. Not as often as it is now. I mean, my God, the amount of new content that gets put out daily, nothing compares to the output we have today.
Yeah.
It's nuts.
Yeah, I'm sure.
There's at least 20 companies producing 30 scenes a month. That's 600 right there. And if you think we did 4 to 5 scenes a movie, 4 movies a month, 20 scenes. 20 scenes is all we're giving you back in like DVD day like 2 years ago. No, more like 5 years ago. You mentioned you worked for or you were under contract for somebody.
Paul Norman.
Whoa. Now, what company was that? Was that his own?
You know what? Basically, I was under contract with Paul Norman, the director. So whoever hired him or whoever hired me hired the other one. We were basically a package deal.
Do they have like VCA Pictures or Hustler or Penthouse or any of that?
All that stuff was around. I did a lot of stuff for Pleasure, actually.
Wow, Pleasure Productions.
Pleasure Productions.
Wow. And they lived on for a really long time.
I haven't heard of them.
That was a porn company that started in the film era, I think, in New York and lived all the way through the DVD era. But they left long before piracy. Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
those are the guys you work for, Joey.
Yeah.
The fucking Italians.
Also too, they did the productions, but then they got into distribution.
Yeah, fucking lots of other really cool things, and we always worked and always got paid. And
so they were just paying off cops, and is that kind of how?
It was a permit thing. They wanted to make sure people got their money, so they made sure people were paid.
Yeah.
No one ever got hurt. No one ever got killed. No whatever. It just was porn.
Yeah.
And it hadn't broken into that social media of, fuck, the whole world wants this stuff.
Yeah.
Because think about it. People can say we're filthy fucking people. Well, there's a million buyers that keep coming to us every year.
That's true.
Who's really dirty?
Well, the same people. I'm sure the same people that are openly against it are probably buying porn.
Are usually
porn.
The ones getting like girls in privates.
Yeah, and they're the ones that are doing probably like the nastiest shit.
Oh, fuck. They're getting banged in the ass while they're trying to burn the Bible the next day. And you're like, bro, what are you doing?
And then they're going to confession on Sunday.
Exactly.
And starting again on Monday.
America, the fucking proud. Here we go. Let's start this thing up.
It's always like
because they've psychologically proven people in power want to be really fucking subdued and
dominated.
Dominate.
Yeah, well, if you already have all the money and everyone, you know, you can boss everybody around and, you know, sometimes
you need a break.
You need a break. You need somebody to tap you in the ass.
Now it's time to be some 19-year-old's bitch.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Plus, they can't openly be like that anyways, right?
I like that social dynamic. What do you think about the whole Bruce Jenner thing and him coming out as a transgender or I don't want to get it wrong.
Good for him.
I think it's great. I wish the dude would do like a fashion layout in like Playboy or something and be like, hey, Bruce Jenner.
The only thing is he's not
won the Olympics.
He's not really like a hot transgender.
Dude, he's like the GILF. He's like the full-blown fucking, he could own the GILF category. Boom. Does he still have a package down there or what's the story?
He's either got rid of it or he's working on getting rid of it, I think.
What would that go for on
eBay?
Doesn't
he have to dress up as a woman for like over a year or a year before they'll do the cleat sex change. I believe that he has to go through like where he plays a woman for a year.
Stop. Yeah, they don't have like, that. Like, what?
Oh, he has to like
go through hormones and like.
I mean, the hormone, or just actually just be a woman like on the streets
actually
walking
kind of
around
living like a woman.
Yeah. Oh, wait, really?
Who regulates
so
that?
So psychologically, you know, your head's into it, and it's not like this, you know, fly by the night kind of decision or choice that you're trying to make.
So there's no second thoughts. Yeah. Well that kind of makes sense.
My head's thinking, well, I was drinking last night. I want to be a hot broad. Yeah, King, give it time. You're just hungover. Fuck.
Well, I heard he's got another, like, he's got a
boyfriend?
Woman. He said he's still interested in women, but he wants to be a woman.
So he's like a lesbian. That's cool.
I never could understand. Why not just keep it?
No, it's not about, like.
Keep the package.
But why not just keep it? You can still.
Tuck it.
Yeah.
Tuck it.
Why get rid of it?
But it's up to
because you don't
some
want it. Like, your brain doesn't want it.
In today's
it's a
society.
Psychological
penetrated.
Thing.
You want to be penetrated. You don't want to penetrate anymore.
But he's can do that.
Wow, part of the whole being
he's already got a hole for that, though. What does he need?
He can still
if I was
be
a guy, I'd put it up the ass and jack my cock off. I think that is fucking hot.
I totally want to talk.
Would you really?
It's kind of kinky. It's kind of a hot, interesting kind of thing.
Getting banged in the ass while you jerk off. Wow. Wow.
Well,
that's great. That's great.
First time I've ever said.
I think it's great that you have that in your mind. And last night on the phone, you're asking me, hey, should I go to this thing called Sturgis? I'm like, yes. Change your life and go to the greatest motorcycle run of all time.
Well, what if his girlfriend wants him to
that's
do
hot
her with the strap on? I mean, then he's going to think that he might as well have just kept the dick.
No, but it's different.
But yeah, you can't feel anything.
Removing your junk
it's
means
about
you
the way,
no
like
longer blow a load.
That's what I'm saying. So what do you do? Like, how do you get off then?
That's
you still get off.
You how?
No, you can't.
You don't have
you
it.
Get off.
You've hacked the balls off.
You hacked the balls, hacked
you now
the dick.
No longer have the pleasure fucking sack.
I knew trans women who could get off with, like, their, like, new clit and vagina.
They make a clit?
They make a clit out of your penis.
That's right.
They make a
don't
clit
do that to me.
The penis is basically just a giant clit. So
don't.
What they do is they take the nerves from
don't
the penis.
And it works?
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't.
You can get off.
Oh.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Really?
Yep. Uh-huh. Well, because some women have such a big clit, it could be a little penis. You know?
I've seen penises so small
true
they look
but
like they kill it.
I think
the clit actually turns
a dude
into
with
a
balls.
Dick
so you're telling me they're going to take some ball nerve endings?
No, not the balls.
And no,
the
dick. But
the dick. It's all in the dick.
My point is this. You take Bruce Jenner's dick off, and how's he going to get off? Because now he has no balls.
Well, he's not going to squirt. He's just going to get off,
yeah.
I guess. Nothing happens.
But are you going to take the ball material and turn it into a clit?
No, you turn it into the labia.
Yeah, no, the...
I think...
Yeah.
Right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
The lips. The balls are the lips anyways.
They take the nerve ending like, from the penis, turn that into the clit,
okay,
and then they take the ball sack and make the labia.
Yeah, they make the labia out of the ball sack.
That's
but
pretty,
shit,
that's
but I can... Okay, I get it. They're taking
labia
the nerves from the dick and making the clit, but the nerves from the dick is like, you know, several inches away, so how do they snip that and then put it, you know, flush with the skin?
It's
flush with the
magic
skin. Right?
without trimming nerve endings.
Yeah. Well, you can't just cut the dick off, take the tip, and then cut the nerve out of that, and then sew that back on.
I've seen a guy get dick surgery that way. It works.
I've seen porn just like that.
He chopped the whole cap off and fucking added veins from his thigh and
made it bigger
and cracked it.
Oh, that's fucked up though. That's gross.
Back in the 90s.
He added 4 inches to it.
Back in the 90s.
No,
I'm not going to say who.
Frankencock? No way.
No, but it was all polished out, and he was just banging these broads like nobody's business.
So does that mean if somebody has the same blood type, you could get skin from another person?
Ew, stop.
Like you could get like a black dude or something like that and make it half and half?
You all of a sudden have a black cock.
You're like, bro, check this out.
I get a black one just so it would just...
I have Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's fucking basketball famous cock.
What? But you got to make sure the thickness is the same. Otherwise, it'll be weird. It'll be two different thicknesses in the middle. Right?
No, you'd have to shape it.
It would look like a baseball bat or something.
If you're adding a fender on a car, you'd have to sand it.
Oh, yeah.
You might have to cut. We're going to sand down some cock shaft here later on in a minute. Really? How did this even go to that point? I love it.
Oh, so confusing. Well, I'm just glad that we're in a day and age that he can come out and be honest and be able to pursue his sexuality.
I think it's great. Yeah. I think it's incredibly great because he's a world-known, internationally world-known Olympic athlete. But his kids are such fucking, really?
Are they against it?
Isn't Kardashian his kid?
Oh, what?
Dude, really?
Really?
Oh, my God. Yeah, Kim Kardashian.
Kim Kardashian.
Kylie and Kendra are.
Please don't associate.
Kylie and Kendra are his kids.
Oh, I didn't know that.
The two youngest are his kids, and the other ones are Chris and her husband, who is OJ's lawyer. He died of cancer.
I used that guy one time.
Which lawyer?
Not Johnny Cochran.
Well, no, it would have been... which one died?
Dark hair.
Little white guy. Shapiro.
Is he the guy who...
Shapiro.
Robert Shapiro?
Robert Shapiro.
Did he defend some serial killers in the...
He defended me in a DUI.
Did he?
Thank you very much. They were going to hang me to die. And I walk in all pimped out suit. Morning, Judge.
Yeah, I think Robert Shapiro defended Son of Sam or something like that.
Son of fucking Sam. Really?
Something like that.
Yeah,
he defended some serial killer or something like that.
I have no idea who like any of these people are.
Son of Sam?
Because you're a baby.
I know.
Which is adorable.
I'm just like listening to you guys. I'm like clueless.
Taking her around Hollywood, they were like, really, dude? Is that your daughter?
That's hot, though.
Oh, yeah. And she's like fucking stripping on Hollywood Boulevard. Take pictures of my titties. That's hot.
I was like, look at my ass.
How old are you, doll? How old are you?
I'm 23.
And she looks 16. It's so fucking outlaw.
That's how old I was when I got into a doll, actually.
Oh, yay.
We went in to buy booze, and they're like, she needs ID. And I'm like, what if I'm buying? And they're like, we need her ID. Well, my daughter's a filthy whore. Can't help but get her liquor, buy her condoms. Even drive her to her date. God damn it. Oh. Oh, man.
Actually, you know what? That would be pretty funny to do that in public. Like, go places with her and just act like you're her dad.
Oh,
and
my
give her a big
God.
Kiss on the mouth.
Oh, that's so hot. You should fucking do that.
A tongue in the ass. God damn, my daughter's filthy.
That's like totally one of my fantasies. I just want to, like,
that's
fuck people up.
That's us driving
with that.
On Hollywood Boulevard.
Oh, was that, when was that? Today?
Like, 4 days ago.
Look at my pussy.
And this is a dressed outfit. Wait, Shayla, can you even get in on... Will it darken?
Here.
Hold it way.
Oh, yeah. It's pulled to the side.
Right, here we go. It's fucking right. She's hanging out, bro. Just bam.
Super cute.
We got people shopping on the boulevard. Cops right behind us. I'm like, show me your cunt. It's kind of hot right now.
Are you from L.A., honey?
No, I'm living in Oakland. I'm from the East Coast. I'm from New Jersey, originally.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Very cool.
I'm moving here. I'm moving to the Valley.
Robert Kardashian is the lawyer.
Probably.
Are you? Of course.
Oh.
You're going to pursue porn, right?
Right.
Become the Valley girl.
Oh, God, no.
I was like, you probably don't even know what that is.
Wait, do you know what Valley girl is?
I kind of know it.
Saying, like,
there's like a movie about a Valley girl, and her dad was a really famous
I just know
musician.
Valley girls are like obnoxious.
Well, yeah. Okay, so you got the gist of the movie in one word. That'll go. Obnoxious. Done. Next.
Oh my God. Okay.
Shayla. All right. Shayla, what are you doing? Don't you have a website? Talk about it.
I do. Shayla.com.
Spell that.
And I also have a Clips for Sale store.
Ooh.
Clips Studio 80835.
80835 for sale of Laval.
Yes, what, for my eclipse for sale. Yep. And we're going to put some smoking stuff up soon.
Are these new? Is this new together. Stuff? New, brand new, or is there? Are
it's
there...
all new stuff.
Oh, okay, cool.
Wait, Josh is wanting to get some footage. He's like, really, Shayla? I'm. Josh is over here just staring at those titties. He has not stopped looking at your titties.
I'm staring at your tits too. It's cool.
You know you're right. I can't help it.
And Josh, in full corduroy coat, is like. So are these new scenes, Shayla?
I had to make sure that they were camera ready.
Good Lord.
But I can't help it.
I love them.
Thank you.
I want to bury my face in your tits.
I would like to have other hands on them other than my own. Give me your hands.
There we go.
Yes.
There we go.
Where else can people find you? Do you like cam shows or...
I do cam shows. They can email me at Shayla@Shayla.com.
Right.
So everything is very simple to get a hold of me. I am. My Twitter handle is at Shayla Laveau.
Spell that. Spell Laveau. Spell Laveau because there's a lot of un-French people.
Yeah. LAVEAUX.
Nice. I just want to see you shake your head like that. So
I didn't know there was, I wouldn't have known there was an X in it.
Laveau. Yeah, French word. Exactly.
Oh, you added the X.
Oh, really? Laveau doesn't really have an X. Oh, shit.
You fake.
I'm spelling it. Oh, it's different.
Bordeaux and, you know, there's various things. So I was like, well, let's just add an X on so it would be unique and different.
Nice.
My manager came up with my last name. I didn't want a last name, and my manager came up with it.
So I like it.
I would have been happy just being Shayla.
What does it mean?
Yeah. I was told I needed a last name.
What does it mean? Is there meaning to it?
The calf.
Bam! Someone retweeted that motherfucker as soon as we got on it. That was odd.
Am I supposed to have my phone out here? Am I supposed to be like tweeting shit?
No. Well,
I was being like respectful.
No, you should see if people are tweeting you. Because people might be asking questions. So, like, it's so cute because Amy hit me up a week ago. Coming down from Oakland, and you really shot how much? Like, what had you done before we met a week ago?
I shot, like, kink stuff. Kink and intersec in the Bay.
Really? You shot intex? Wow. Like, BDSM scenes?
Yeah. That's, like, what I do in my personal life, so.
Really?
I like getting, like, dommed.
It seems like,
What's your favorite kind of dom scenario?
Like, Shayla jumped on that so fast. I just want to point that out.
Like, kind of like a dominant gangbang, like getting kidnapped and like tied up, and then having like a ton of guys just like fuck me,
door.
Use my holes and shit.
Lock the fucking studios or explain to the wife later.
You're gonna get me in trouble, Chris.
Whoa!
But there's gotta be some rope and a little bit of like flapping around and like.
Oh, no. Really?
Not choking.
No, not yet, but I'm sure they're coming.
Yeah, I love that shit.
Snacking.
A little bit
Are
of pain.
You nudge, Chris?
I'm completely enamored by everything that's going on. I don't feel like I'm like, I don't touch the ground right now. I'm just so, kind of floating
Chris,
along.
Chris, have you worked with both of these girls?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah, Shayla, many times in many, many, many cool places.
Yeah.
The best place we shot was the Valley of Fire like 2 years ago out in Las Vegas.
Oh, okay, cool.
But it looked like, fuck. Oh, no, right here. Right. And there it is. The wife kicks me in. Boom.
Uh-oh.
Don't forget the wheel. Okay, good. Good. I thought she was going to be like, Josh needs to go home after the show.
Don't forget what?
Nothing. It's you know.
The wheel of truth.
We have the wheel of truth. We spin this giant wheel, and I can't see that well. Funny being a photographer and all, but my cameras are adjusted properly, but that's not the point. Something shut off.
We're full on that one.
Bull. I wish you could see the display screen behind us right now. It just says bull. Boom. In big letters. But it's all right. We're running two GoPros, so that looks like that's going to be the start of the broadcast, and then we'll kick into this camera and throw in the amazing audio by our amazing technician, Martina.
So what's the weirdest – what's the most – I guess the weirdest dom scene that you did. Did you ever do pony play
actually,
or any of that weird shit?
The one that really stands out for me was like, I was in the New York subway station, and my dominant at the time just like threw me on the ground in the subway and had me like lick the tops of, I don't know if I licked the bottoms of his boots, but I definitely licked the tops. And then he pulled my panties, I was wearing a skirt, so he pulled my panties down like part way, and I just like walked home like that. It was a couple blocks, but still. I just was like dripping wet. I was like afraid that like it could see. Like,
this is like a true life story, or
yeah,
a
no,
scene?
This isn't a scene. Then this
no,
is just
this is like back when
fuck,
this is my pre-porn
yeah.
days. I did like a triple whatever, like a airtight thing in my pre-porn days.
Airtight?
Too.
Do you understand that?
What is that?
One in the puss, one in the ass, one in the mouth.
That's triple pen? Is that
it's airtight?
Yeah, I heard they call it airtight in porn, but
airtight.
It's like the same thing as
triple okay, so pen. Just one in each.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Think about that, though. You could add two more dudes you're jerking off. Five guys in a room.
I would be too distracted.
I want to do it on camera, too. I only did it in my personal life, so.
Is there a such thing as a DVDA? A double anal, double vagina.
You know, it's so funny. She's being asked to do an anal.
I don't know if it's happening or not.
And double vag.
I don't know if it's happening.
The same, a double anal,
asked.
Double vag.
No.
Oh.
Anal, double vag.
My agent just said maybe
one
I could do it. I don't know if it's
one
happening.
Anal, double vag.
Yeah.
Okay. One in the ass, two in the puss. But you'll end up peeling out of
how do you position yourself that way? How does the third person not
rub
get in the way?
Dicks.
There's
dicks.
A lot of different.
Boom. We were talking about that coming down here today.
That's the only thing about this is when I seen the rubbing the,
Josh,
the two
lube
dicks
up
touching.
Your cock,
it kinda,
I'm gonna be right next to you, bro. I'll fucking anchor and you get in there. No. All right.
Yeah.
Josh immediately looks away. Going, oh. Oh fuck! I know I said I'd be on the show tonight, but dude.
Honey, have you ever done that in your personal life? Have you ever done a double
hell
vag
no.
anal
I've
in your
never
personal?
Done a double vag or a double anal.
But she's done an airtight at home.
Yeah.
So that's like North Carolina,
wow.
South Carolina. You don't really know the difference. It's not like, well, I didn't do this at home, but I had all my holes filled.
Wow.
I think it's kind
wow.
of cool.
I love just I like having that. My hose filled up. I love like the objectification too and that kind of shit. Like, I'm oh. just going to use your body. And, like, they'll let dirty talk.
I've never heard this explanation. I have no idea.
You're
what's going on.
I'm
going to
take you.
Wow.
I never heard the term airtight. That makes sense.
Airtight. Airtight's
I couldn't do
rad.
It, but I'll appreciate watching it.
I
love people being like, I want to use your, like, filthy holes, and you're just, like, a piece of meat and shit like that. I love the dirty talk.
Ooh. Not girl. So when did you become sexually active? When did you get your cherry pop?
Can we legally say that?
When I became sexually active with someone else or by myself?
You got to hear the by herself thing. It's creepy.
Well, let's start with by yourself and work our way with someone.
About
that?
Five.
Start with some tears. Five.
Five?
Five. I had like fantasies of like being tied up and shit when I was
yes.
five.
Oh my God.
I'm thinking about my ham sandwich at lunch and a fucking nap and she's working one down.
I also
I was, yeah,
left a career
thinking about Ninja
computer awesome. Science for porn. That's how much I love sex.
Oh my God.
I have a degree
you can always fall back on that
yeah,
later.
Yeah, I have a degree
go
in theoretical
the
computer
now.
Science, and I was like, I really love sex, and I want to like do that. So
we're building up all the sexuality, and Martina's already put her hand up in the air that we're about to go away for commercial break.
No.
It's the joy of real. We have three sections.
We gotta
you know those three
we
fingers?
3 minutes.
Three fingers is basically airtight. Well, no, that's
no,
more
I
like...
No, like I get a...
Two in the pink, one in the stink. Yeah. Okay, so go back to your 5-year-old masturbation fantasy. Can't believe I said
yeah,
that.
Yeah, no, I had like.
I know, right? Now you're going to get us in trouble.
I just fired
go
myself.
Go back to your 5-year-old masturbation scene.
Kindergarten.
No,
fingers.
But I was playing like in the playground and shit. I don't know if I'm like legally allowed
fingers.
To say this or like this.
I don't
but anyway.
Know. We're going to have to edit this entire section.
Yeah, I don't know. We should bring that up.
But I had my like friends, you know, it's edit later, whatever. So I had my friends.
But we're live right now.
We're live.
Fuck.
There is no 5-second intermission.
Yeah.
Janet Jackson can have a fucking wardrobe malfunction, and we hope she sucks dick at the same time. Can you imagine that if she would have just said, fuck it, here's my other titty. You want to see my asshole?
Yeah.
It's super.
Wait, I haven't seen your asshole, though, or your pussy. Is that later?
Yeah.
That's later. Yeah. Okay.
Because we haven't really determined the amount of hardcore we're willing to put out. It's bad enough I tweeted your butthole all week for the Red Gorilla Network. Did you notice
that? You did?
No, which
was a lot of, like, very oral cavities of Amy Faye's body all week. On
really?
Twitter. Oh, yeah.
We did. And that. I'm sure you were just tortured happening to do it.
It's a rough job.
Well, I might have saw the butthole,
truly,
but not seen her face.
It is, but somebody's got to do it.
You know, and just as the 1 minute break hits us, we start talking about buttholes. It's perfect timing here on Real Seduction.
Am I going to be showing my butthole?
We can put it up on the screen here.
Butthole. Yeah, we need to.
It's more fun if it's like live, though.
This was more public butthole at shopping at.
Oh, he was in a store.
At Busy Bee.
Yeah.
It's this, like, porn store that makes the most amazing wardrobe on earth.
Oh, where was this at?
Who is
and
that?
Busy Bee. And she's trying on a little micro mini, and I'm like, I should probably get a good selfie of your butthole. And she's like, that's a great idea.
That is sexy.
Which is killer, because...
I would like to lick it from clit to butthole.
Oh, my God, yes.
Ain't a problem.
Stop getting me wet.
There we go.
I'm going to get, like, my pussy cream, like, all over this chair.
And that's a true story, dude. She does.
I get super wet.
Because editing a scene I shot of her, it was, like, soaking wet, and we're going away. Shayla, stay with us. Before Jesus came, in building a mystery,
we live in a church where you sleep with voodoo dolls and you won't give up the search.
Are you ready to take your music to the next level? Do you need music written for your commercial or film? Are you in need of a voiceover or ADR for your project? How about a music producer? StageRit Studios has got you covered. StageRit Studios is located in Burbank, California, and offers a professional creative team of producers, writers, and engineers to ensure your creative vibe is captured. Visit us on the web at StageRitStudios.com or give us a call at 818-855-9210 to book your session. Get the StageRit Studios experience.
World's finest smoke shop, Smoke in Heaven, has moved to sunny Burbank, California, right off Magnolia and Hollywood Way. Smoke in Heaven remains the only smoke shop in U.S. that guarantees to beat any price in U.S. or it's free.
Free.
Made in U.S. guaranteed. We care about quality. Mention this ad and receive a
free
hookah. For directions and info, that's
Smoke in Heaven
on Yelp.com or call us at 310-754-5005 at Smoke in Heaven. That's 310-754-5005.
The Vintage Soul Project, an urban sound with a retro twist. Check out their new EP, arranged and produced by Robert E. Lee. Now available on iTunes. The Vintage Soul Project.
Lakers shirts dope with an urban appeal? Then check out West West Clothing. Check us out on the web, first of all, at westwest.spreadshirt.com, where we got all the tight stuff. We got hoodies, t-shirts, coming out with a girls line called Shake That Bear. We got all the sizes for you. We got the slim small, the mediums, the tight larges. And then check us out on Instagram, bwestf50 or jwest199024 for those hot West West Wednesdays. That means that we're dropping a new article of clothing every Wednesday for the summer. Make it hot. So if you want it, you want to say something, you want those tight shirts, go to West West Clothing, westwest.spreadshirt.com.
Tight. Hi, I'm Alexa Nova. When I'm not getting fucked in the ass, I'm listening to Real Seduction.
And we're back. Shayla LaVeau, perfect fucking timing. We drop in with Sarah McLachlan. Hopefully YouTube will let us use this because they blocked me on my copy. Come out at night. I do weird things to your butthole.
Yeah. That's what she's really saying in this song.
Come out and do weird things to your butthole at night.
So, Amy, did you have anal sex or vaginal sex first?
I first had vag. I didn't do anal until I was, like, 19.
Okay.
Yeah. So well, 5 years.
And actually, somebody on Twitter said that I did an airtight thingamajigga.
You don't even remember.
In the bootay and in the hoo-hoo and in the mouth.
Yes, at the same remember. Time. Did you do that?
You don't remember?
I didn't remember.
You don't remember? Dude, the 90s?
93 to 2015.
93, dude. I was skinny and had hair down to here, and I did porn with tearaway leather fucking pants.
Yes, you told me. You mentioned that before.
Naughty.
The tearaway
lens. So you had easy access?
Oh, God. It was all about being the cheesy guitar player that sucked, but I'd book gigs because I'd bang managers. You cannot stop looking at that. Really? Just go to the butthole pic. Have you seen the butthole
pic? I have not seen the butthole
pic. This is what happens when you go shopping with Amy.
Wow, I should go shopping with Amy more often.
You can go shopping with me if you buy me shit.
Oh, yeah. Shit.
She's not stupid.
If only I was rich, you know?
Very smart little girl.
She's no dummy.
Shayla, you're proud of her for that. You're all happy.
I'm very proud of her for that.
So cute.
You go.
She's well trained. She's
for free.
No.
No way.
Gas, or ass?
Remember gas, that old or grass?
Gas, grass, or ass?
Yeah.
Nobody rides for free. Rides for
I used
free.
To have a sticker that said that.
These are the most random photos cool. on your phone.
Look, yeah, here's me in prison. Bam, you like that? Bam.
Nice.
Why is Chris King in prison? Who knows? I'm just fucking...
And they let you keep your sunglasses on.
I know, huh? And take selfies.
Yeah, taking selfies for
myself. I'm Johnny Cash, and I'm taking a selfie. God damn it.
Ah, Johnny Cash.
I like Johnny Cash.
I love Johnny.
So
I'm
we got...
Big Johnny Cash fan.
Really?
Yeah, I love Johnny Cash.
Remember how he always said he would never be photographed wearing all white unless all the homeless were cared for?
I didn't know that.
That was a quote a long time ago. Everyone's like, Johnny Cash, why do you only wear black? And he goes, I'm doing it on behalf of all the homeless in America. I'm reaching out to the Americans. And once we address and take care of all those people, I'll wear white again. And this was a thing he said back in like 1960.
Now,
and you wore black every single day?
But a guy named Lee Wiener, photographer, famous guy in the 60s and 70s. 50s, too. Photographed like Gandhi, Queen of England, all this stuff.
Yeah.
Did a series of Johnny Cash in 1962 wearing all white.
Really?
Fucking crazy. The guy died, left the collection to his son. He never did anything with it.
They never got released?
He'd lease the photos from other collections of Gandhi and whatnot to, like, corporations so that you could have, like, an original black and white print of Gandhi.
Yeah.
Not a copy. But the Johnny Cash series, I don't think it went anywhere. I told him, dude, really? You got to take this to Beverly Hills to a gallery.
Yeah.
Call it Who Needs Money When You Got Cash and just fucking change the world.
Yeah.
Dude, Johnny Cash holding a Luger sideways like a fucking gangster, but in 62.
Wow.
So all these motherfuckers say OG, you're like, sit down, you've just been owned by Johnny Cash.
No.
More badass than, like, anybody. Come on, it's Cash. Who's more badass than Johnny Cash?
No one.
Just
no
silence.
One I think of.
No.
Now, here's another fucking weird concept. What if Elvis played while evil jumped?
What
if Elvis would have set up in the parking lot?
Well,
and all of a sudden, he
went,
and you know he's going to eat shit. So you're like, dude, best show ever, bro. What the fuck? Eat shit. Create monster concerts, dude.
That would have been cool.
Elvis, can
you? Where do you come up with this shit?
I just. Why would you not? I mean, think about that. It's kind of an easy thought, though. Like, 1970, you got Evel Knievel. Or no, 1969, and he's jumping Caesar's Palace. Right? Good year.
You're right. That's
and he's jumping the fucking fountain. Why not go, Elvis, bring your fucking buddies out and fucking jam out front? We'll make like a barbecue.
How about if Evel jumps over him?
That's what I mean.
Evil Elvis.
Oh, yeah. The horses and the fucking ambulances.
Just, that would be cool. Giant fucking just five balls of fire.
Elvis doing the final chorus standing on an ambulance. Viva!
That'd be cool.
What? And he shuts the doors while they roll fucking Evil out. Later, bro.
They could probably do a hologram version of that.
They should, you know, talk about parody, CG, all this kind of fucking... I would be a huge fan of that.
That would be cool.
Like, I'm not the comic book guy. I wish I was, because, like, people are so into that whole fucking Comic-Con and parodies, which is cool. But I don't know why. I just see Elvis Presley being jumped by Evel Knievel. It'd be fucking stupidly cool.
As a comic book fan myself, I have to say, for the comic community, they would be just as into that as you would be.
Or what about, like, Johnny Cash banging the snot out of Marilyn?
That would be cool.
Just fucking pig fucking her like no.
That would be
you filthy whore.
Oh my God.
That would be probably the most hardcore porn ever. Think about it. Johnny's
backstage just all whored out, all fucking high. Johnny's like, shut up, bitch, goddamn, I'm Johnny Cash. Fuck you. Sponsored by like Jack Daniels. What the fuck? Really?
He could be playing guitar too.
Oh, and she's blowing him.
Yeah.
She's just down there clearing him out. Put her on, like, little wheels so you can just cruise around standing.
She could hum the melody.
When Marilyn Manson first started doing shows, he used to have, like, peak girls give him full-on fellatio on stage. So it would be that. It would be Johnny Cash hiring Marilyn Monroe to give him full-on fellatio.
He had the girls in a cage on the stage, and he would stick his dick in the cage.
He was dating Stoya. Do you remember who Stoya is?
Yeah. Yep.
Holy Christ. And she's
Marilyn
like,
Manson. Marilyn Manson was married to Dita Von T.
What? I didn't even know that.
Yeah. Holy right? Shit.
From Dita to Stoya to like, dude, fuck Stoya? You. I'm so fucking bored. And dude, after that, there's like, there's nothing you could do after. You're like, I'm good.
Evan Rachel Wood.
Who?
Evan Rachel Wood. You don't know who Evan Rachel Wood is? I don't know that. She's really hot. You should look her up right now.
You know who I'm
right now.
She's super
We're
fucking
all
hot.
Creeping.
Did you guys? My buddy, not gonna say his name, but he used to be Marilyn Manson's personal assistant, and like, he would tell me stories of like just doing insane amounts of like blow with Marilyn Manson and Rachel Wood.
He kind of brought back the whole Jim Morrison way of living, really.
Yeah.
But he didn't die.
Just
say, buddy, live. Evelyn Rachel, wow, he's just banging her. Oh,
oh shit.
Let me see.
That girl's hot.
She's smoking.
Redheaded Amy Faye. You just run around.
How does he get these girls?
I don't know.
He's not like the
You're
most
Marilyn
attractive
Manson.
Guy.
You can be butt the fuck ugly, dude.
But these are hot girls that can get hot guys, too, and rich guys.
Hot chicks aren't into good, reliable, or nice. They're into just douchebags. Come on.
Yeah.
On.
There's a lot of douchebags that are attractive.
Bad boys.
Marilyn Manson's pretty ugly ass.
Yeah, but he's
guy.
The ultimate
he's
freaky
ugly.
Dude.
He's really,
really
ugly, right?
He's ugly. Like, no.
But when he embraces his ugliness. And you see these chicks, you're like, what a fucking whore. I couldn't wait to find. I can taste your ass from here. So he just shows up going, yeah, Marilyn Manson. They're like, oh, God. They just fucking swallow his balls.
He
fuck, in a heartbeat. They're like, yeah, we should camp out for a couple weeks and just party in Australia.
Did you ever see when I tried on his stilts once? You know,
tried on Marilyn Manson's stilts.
Yeah, I got in trouble in that.
That's an actual thing.
Yeah, he has stilts. He puts these stilts on his legs and he walks around like he's
what?
You never seen it?
No.
Yeah, they're like
you're backstage, like getting in his.
No,
in his gear.
No, I was at a rehearsal place.
Just drunk.
And he was practicing there. And he left them out by the rehearsal, so I just put them on.
Marilyn, I'm grabbing your stilts.
Yeah, I was trying to take that a selfie, and they told me to get off them.
That's fucking great.
Yeah.
You didn't, like, try to drive a car. You just walked around.
No, I just was trying to walk around the hallway with him.
Nice. And did he say something?
No, he wasn't there. People? No, he set him down. He went out for, like, a break or something like
that's
that.
That's classic.
And they had him, like, set aside, so I was like, oh, that's the stilts.
Fuck,
I've seen him for years.
I'm riding them.
I've seen him on the still. I was a big Marilyn Manson fan, so I've seen him come out from like Ozfest. Nice. Come out with he wears this like weird bald cap with goggles and this weird puppet thing. Whoa. And he does, and he's like comes out and he's like 12 feet tall or something.
See,
like
I
that.
Only saw one show he played. He opened up, or no, he Slayer opened up for them.
Oh yeah, his shows are incredible.
And nobody notices. It's like, oh, you're wearing a Nazi helmet. Oh, it's cool. It's their American flag.
Yeah.
And then he drops these banners, and you're like, well, they had those in Berlin in '39. Yeah. You're just putting a music symbol. Whoa.
Yeah, he puts his.
And I'm the old guy at the show going, does anyone see this? It's weird. And they're like, what do you mean? It's beautiful. And I'm like,
it's beautiful.
Well, no, that was the whole theme of it. He had the podium. He had the outfit, and then he was ripping out Bibles. Ripping the pages out of the Bible.
It's always the super religious dudes that get really fucking creepy. Not creepy, but perverse. I was raised really conservative, and I like weird sex.
Because you were raised conservatively.
Yeah, yeah. Conservative don't people are the ones who like the craziest shit.
Fuck yeah. Josh, how was, wait, didn't you record something? Wait, that was last week. Long recording day.
I recorded something today, too.
Nice. So, like, here at, it's not Red Gorilla Studios, it's...
Next door is Stage Red Studios.
That's, and is there a link on our website to get them back to you?
You know, I don't know if we put on the website. Maybe we should, though. We should
totally do that.
We have a recording studio next door that we... That we run. That's what we had first, and then.
Oh, nice!
Because it was kind of cool.
What made you get into this?
Did Brandon find you?
Me and Brandon, the other owner of the network, used to do podcasts. John Lovitz. He had one at the John Lovitz Club, and then me and him ran our own podcast out of our house, and then. We just decided to make a network, basically. One of the networks, the network that Chris was on before, went down, and we kind of picked
them up. We had 22 shows, 22 different channels. We were making money, bringing in little porn stars past the bar. Brandon was a bartender. We had to call you at the gate. It was a big deal, City Walk. You knew you were getting late after the show that time, every time it was killer.
Oh, nice.
And we kept getting bigger. And bigger and bigger, and we brought on corporate sponsors. And then we signed the NFL, and our the owner of the station cashed a check and left the country. So literally on my 13th show, I walk in and the text is sitting in a pile of wires going, oh, no, dude, you didn't get the email. I'm like, what do you mean? Did we move? He goes, we're done. It's over. He left the country with a 17-year-old wife and two kids. What? And I'm like, dude, so Real Seduction Radio took a huge dump because, like, when he left and took all the money, he kind of forgot to pay iTunes, so we lost all of our shows.
Yeah.
22 times 15, I'm not even good at math, but yeah, I'm not even going to look it up because I'm that slow.
Yeah.
All those shows are gone. That's why if you look on our website here at the Red Gorilla Network, I was actually able to save 5 of those shows.
Yeah, they're on the website.
Because I ran the board. There's no video to them because that got deleted. But we do have original recordings from, like, Gary Miller, the producer of the AVN Awards. Natasha and Natalia. Teal Conrad. I don't remember anyone else. I think we had Celeste Star. It was like 3 years ago. But anyways, that's why we're back and that's why we're here.
Nice. Well, we're glad that you're back, Chris.
No, this is killer. I think this is our 9th show here at Red Gorilla.
Yeah.
Nice.
Every Tuesday. And, you know, it's so cool to have you on board because I've known you for so long, and I'd rather, like, honestly, keep it real, talk to people in the business that offer a different perspective. Mm-hmm. Anybody can get free porn. Anybody can, like, look you up, but they'll never really get to know who you are unless you, like, get real about it. Hence Real Seduction.
So we're really seducing them, and it's real seduction, and get up close and smell and get to know the stars.
I'll send you that $20 for the endorsement thing. That was perfect. As you're saying real and you're shaking the tits, I'm like, I love you so much. Oh, my God. You could sell fucking manure. Shayla's like, hey, buy some poo, and people are just lining up. What are we buying? No, I don't care. I'm just seeing Danny's.
Well, it's cool, though, but for me, this is a great other aspect because I don't do a lot of radio unless I know someone. I've done Ginger Lynn. I've done several of her radio shows. I don't know. I just don't like my own interviews very well. And I'm super close to you and you're comfortable and I enjoy talking to you. So I need
thank you.
To be a good gig.
Yay. Yay. Yeah. Anyways, Shayla and I always seem to manage to, like, get together a couple days before AVN gets going and shoot some cool content. I'm sure we're going to keep doing that.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That's
absolutely. We need to back out to the fire.
Valley of Fire. What the fuck? And you go out there when it's like 104 so you can't even think. And then bring some hot chick and suede bikini and lube her up and be like, look at me now and rub your clit. Yes.
Should we run the wheel? Going.
It's this watch doesn't work. What a
who knows what time it is?
Oh my God, Josh has the timing on perfect. Dude,
are
you
wearing?
Can
I ask something? What is she wearing?
Slide. I know. Jill,
What are you
stand
wearing?
Stand up. We want to see a whole show.
Ooh, yeah.
Okay, I thought it might be something like that.
So, oh, oh my god!
Your butt.
Where are you? Oh, there we go. Hold on.
Oops. Fuck yeah.
Okay, there we go.
Bam. No, that no. You can move that, dude, because we don't see it.
Did you wear that for the show, or is that just what you always wear?
Around that's
usually
how, that's
I'm how, naked, oh. But no, I figured I'd wear it for the show.
Okay. That's you how Shayla sells.
I didn't know if I could be naked.
Yeah, we're not sure about that. We got to check the legalities of it because we could turn this into a filthy little fucking place.
Right?
Well, I think you'd have to just blurb it out, right?
I don't know.
You could put like a little bar.
Because if it's on a porn site that has parental approval or 18 approval,
or go what if, for actually, it. What if you just do
balls on your
you could do
fucking
two
chin.
Versions, one that's
hardcore and a softcore. That means we need crew to like cut around it. No, dude, the wheel goes right behind the computer. I'm sorry.
Sorry, man.
No, it's all good. You haven't done it. It's cool. We don't even know your name. It's great. We brought in this other dude. I think you have a show on this network.
Yeah, yeah.
You do. Wait.
He has
do.
The vape show. The vapor
You're
boys.
One of the vape dudes. Yeah.
I am the vape dude. Okay, come on. Let's be real.
Can you put that wheel right on the table?
Oh, on the table.
And like you got to move the laptop forward.
All right.
Shayla, you're not going to be able to get the full like benefit of this.
I'm here.
Okay, Amy, go ahead and spin the wheel.
Me?
And then don't spin it too hard because it spins really fast. Here we go.
Dun. Don't break it.
Shayla, it looks pretty killer because there's a wheel spinning right behind your head right now. And you don't know what's going on, but it's pretty amazing, so I'm going to send
really
you a
scary.
Picture. That's really hot right there. Okay, and it landed on best and worst fuck buddy. No, it didn't. I'm sorry.
It landed on...
Wait, which is it?
Besides the bedroom... What is your favorite place to fuck?
Okay.
In a creepy van.
Who's first?
Oh, this is an Amy Faye question. It's going okay. straight down
oh,
her
shit. Is it bad that like I honestly haven't had sex in like that many weird places?
What? That's bullshit, though. Come on.
I like the kitchen.
Huh. And not weird.
I know. And I like really dirty bathrooms. But
really dirty.
They
dirty
have
bathroom.
To be dirty, like
shit on the
like,
floor.
No, ew, gross.
Gas station sex. Yeah. Where you pull in and like just roaches. Fucking drop a load, dude. She's in full, like a skirt, and you just fucking pump that pussy full of cum.
Oh, shit.
Get in the car and pull around and be like, yeah, I want a number three with a Coke.
I know a lot of truckers that'd be really mad.
What about fuck?
I did have sex in a tree, and it was really uncomfortable.
In
never
a tree.
Again. Never
nice,
again.
Nice.
It's like really scratchy, like the bark. Like
did you
rubs.
Climb up there knowing you were getting banged?
Yeah.
Let's climb a tree and bang.
What about
that's
no a, bugs?
That's
ants?
Hot. Yeah.
Wasn't any ants or?
Just not
shards
not
of bark.
Shards.
In shards of bark.
You're dragging your butthole against a fine oak.
It would
you're
not recommend
anal...
it. But shards.
That brings out the term anal lesions.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, God, oh.
Yeah, don't slide
like
down
10
the sprinters in her ass.
Shards and lesions.
No. Oh, but
yeah,
I like the idea.
Took us all
like...
uncomfortably quiet, really quiet. Like, oh, no, room. No, yeah, no.
It was a good idea in theory, not in practice.
Not in practice. Well, maybe a treehouse would have been better. Maybe.
Okay. No, but the bathrooms are cool because like I feel like a dirty whore, so it's kind of awesome.
Were you up? How many feet up were you?
Shit, I don't know. Like, not that high.
Like
make
10.
It dangerous. 25. Good chance of breaking
yeah.
it off.
10.
I think that'd be hotter. But
like
the higher,
30 feet
yeah,
up.
The higher you are, the probably the hotter it would be. You know, kind of cool.
No, because you need to be scared, and then like I guess maybe we should be turned on by like dying.
Yeah.
I had a bad habit of banging in Universal City Watch park.
I want to bang in like super public places.
Brandon should really be on the show sharing his like ultimate fantasy.
Throw down, dude. Something about City Walk parking and a girl, and you've like had a nice day at the park, and you're like, we should just bang like fucking stupid people.
I do want to.
And
help
security's
like,
banging on the door. Like, hold on, bro. I'm just bro. Drop the load and go. Okay, we're out here, bro. That's happened. Yeah, I've done that. Let's spin the wheel, dude.
All right.
Not hard. And Shayla's head is now spinning again.
Is this spin for Shayla?
Oh,
yeah, okay, this is a Shayla spin.
Shayla.
This is the all about Shayla spin.
That actually is a cool picture.
What does it say? I gotta read it.
You lost
the album You Lost Your Virginity.
Oh.
Album You Lost. Okay, Shayla, throw down on this. This is gonna be bitching. Your answer will kick ass.
The album I lost my virginity to. It was actually It was my next door neighbor. He was like a few years older than I was. I snuck out,
yeah.
And I didn't have HBO or MTV, and it's when Thriller was huge.
Yes.
So when my cherry was popped, it was during Jackson. Thriller.
Thriller.
Michael Jackson on the television.
Tight red leather zippers gets her off. She sees a chili. Why is my pussy dripping wet?
Yeah. From that day on, she was in a BDSM.
That's an honor than werewolves and zombies.
And right when you were asking the question, I was like, I'm never going to fucking remember that. And I was like, oh, God, yeah, that's something you never forget. And
that's
it was
crazy, painful. Dude. Oh, yeah, first time sex. Amy, was first time sex for you comfortable or not? Or what was it all about?
It was cool. It was, like, super normal and vanilla. Like, it didn't hurt, but it wasn't, like, amazing. Because I didn't know what I was doing. It was kind of like boring.
Really?
Oh. It was fine. It wasn't terrible.
Definitely
it was
not
great.
Amazing. I agree with you.
Yeah,
not
it was
amazing.
Like whatever. It was not a story to be
experimental, kind of nerve wracking, kind of ow. Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Well, I was 17, and nice. My boyfriend at the time was in grad school, and I was like begging him to fuck me for like years, but it was like illegal, what? So he didn't.
17, I think 22.
Yeah.
So it just took a while.
At least 22. You could have taken a little extra time.
Fuck, you get caught banging when you're like 16. But okay, if you're like maybe 17, 18, they're not going to say anything.
Well, if you're... What if
like 29, 39, 49. Yeah. There's you're like peeling off some fucking...
What if you're, what if you're like 16 and 17 and one person turns... 18 and 17.
Well, there's like a
then
law.
It's illegal. There's a law, not like the age difference.
So that'd be like
if you did it before,
busted in California.
There's a law that if you guys
joint.
Are less than 2 years apart.
Yeah.
There is?
Yeah, but so that means that you'd have to be 18 so you couldn't be no.
Well, there's a law in Holland you can fuck your goat, too, but that's weird.
Your goat?
Yeah. It's legal in really? The outskirts of Holland. You can fuck your goat. If you have five acres.
You know,
if it,
if how do you know that, Chris?
I was told
that. I'm packing up and going to Holland. No more vapor shop
we're
boys.
Going to the goat brothel.
Oh, nice. Behani's ripping on
he
the music.
He never too amazing.
What the fuck kind of music is that? What did we play? Oh, my God. We played Sarah McLachlan.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Our co-host hates fucking Irish people. But it won't show up in the press. Hating the Irish. We've been hated for 600 years.
She doesn't hate the Irish because I'm Irish.
Oh, well, then, dude.
Unless she hates me.
What the fuck?
She hate fucks you.
Hate
fucks. That's
fuck.
What she does.
Yeah. She does. She says she doesn't, but she does.
Hate fuck and anal have been two recurring themes.
I think that's
on.
Why she's mad at me all the time. It's kind of a sexual fantasy.
Man. It's like a hate fuck thing, for sure. Yeah. No, she loves you because she hates you.
If we so argue all the time, then it makes the sex better so that she starts fights all the time.
Hate fucking.
I love hate fucking.
Keep your boots on.
Hate
be mad.
Sex.
Yeah. It is makeup sex. That's why you got to argue all the time. So they're just always having makeup sex.
That's exactly. Like, right? Rock passionate motherfucker.
Whoa.
It is. Now. Damn, she's
it is
like,
more passionate, right?
Yeah, totally.
Blaze
yeah.
turned into a bar at closing time. Real quick. She's like, take this, you filthy whore.
Oh, shit. I just remembered. I had like makeup hate sex like in my college library.
So that's the weirdest place you've had sex.
It was a little bit more college public.
Library, there we go.
Because we were having like, those, like deep conversations there, and then it was just like, fuck.
History, art, literature. Not that it matters, but it might get somebody laid.
Probably, considering my school is probably the gay and lesbian studies.
Yeah.
Not,
there's a study on that?
Yeah.
There's study, a major category.
There's a whole class on that?
Dude, yeah.
Really?
No.
Not that anyone cares nearly as much about the weirdest place I've had sex as much as you.
Where?
But,
go.
But weirdest wasn't weird as much as it was awkward. It was like in my best friend's grandparents' house.
I thought you were going to say Jesus. In your best friend's grandparents' mother's
in,
ass.
Wait.
Hey, I'm banging your grandma.
Wait,
she
it
is
doesn't
a
stop
whore.
There. It was in his deceased great-grandmother's bedroom.
Oh, that's creepy.
That's laying down on fucking 200-year-old Ben Gay smelling fucking lace.
I didn't
creepy.
Realize till afterwards. I realized that all the Christian teddy bears were a little creepy.
Oh,
you had all the dolls looking at
yeah, there was pictures of family members all
you
over the
place. You banged into Granny's urn. You knocked Granny's urn down. Your ass just clips Granny's urn. You're like, I'm sorry, old lady.
Like Granny's picture is crying. Oh wait, that's not tears.
Here, look at a picture
Chris,
of your mother.
The
weirdest
place you ever had sex.
The weirdest place I've ever had sex. I was talking about like City Walk parking lot and getting busted. Like, that's literally secure. Well, I wouldn't say weird, because I've had a lot of sex in public. Like, when I was like, when I was 18 in Hollywood, I was just sticking my dick in everything. Jesus Christ. Punk rock. Show up with a mohawk. Hey, look at these chicks. They're not wearing panties. I didn't understand that with punk rock. If a chick showed up in a miniskirt, it'd be like, whoa, you don't wear panties. You're a whore. We should bang. So it was no big deal getting in porn. It was like, you're going to pay me to photograph this. Yeah. Well, I've already got a million pictures. What do you mean, bro? Yeah, she, okay, yeah. Oh, well. Oh, well.
What did she say?
She's like, I don't like Sarah McLachlan. Well, get your own radio show. Oh, no.
I'm surprised.
Now I'm going to get fired.
I'm surprised she's not going to just kick me out of the studio for life for saying that she hate fucks you.
We're 1 minute from wrapping this nicely, freshly pounded load into the ground. Shayla, take us out with something naughty.
We're almost done?
Yeah, we're a minute away from...
Really?
No more.
So you have to go to Shayla.com. You have to email me at Shayla@Shayla.com for cam shows. And clips for sale studio number 80835. And my website, Shayla.com. And, of course, my Twitter, at Shayla Leveau, L-A-V-E-A-U-X. So stop by and say hi, guys.
Yay. Awesome. Amy Faye, bring us all that much social media love.
My Twitter is Amy Faye with an E, XXX. I just made an Instagram, like, today.
Nice.
So, and it's Amy Faye with an R-I-E.
Hurry, we're already fading out. We're losing it. And we're ending the show with ponies running away.
No.
Ponies? I don't know.
Well, sweetie, it was really...
Yeah!
Yes, Skype. Hopefully I'll be able to lick your clit in your butthole one of these
days.
Can I even have your tits?
Right?
Yeah. Butthole cattle stampede.
I want your tongue in my ass.
Thank you for listening to Red Gorilla Network. Make sure to check us out at redgorillanetwork.com for more information on our shows, hosts, guests, and artists. If you'd like to be featured on a show, you may do so by contacting us at 818-855-9210. Thanks for listening. Red Gorilla Network, the Kong of Casting, is broadcasted in Burbank, California. The content on Red Gorilla Network does not necessarily reflect the CEO, staff, host, guest, or artists on the station.
If you have that in the field, but you want to go back to the office and like do it on double screen, you put it into this like bitchin' aluminum case, and it can still understand it with the lid closed.
There's probably some sort of connection.
Once it's plugged in, I bet it still sees stuff. Maybe
who
I can override.
I know Arif on Twitter.
And we never asked that question. Oh, wait. Make some girl propositions.
Wait, who is that, though?
Some fan guy. I think he's a web guy. Okay. Oh! This is the fucking,
I was, like, trying to, like...
Kind of webmaster to...
Like, trying to, like, blow my vape somewhere else because I didn't want to give up.
On her network.
Shit. I was, like...
Yeah, do you guys have, like, taglines you want her to read?
Yeah.
What am I doing?
Taglines. You just...
Chris,